Let's see one very interesting way of copying content of one array to another. I have used the pointers for this copying process. This is one of the very difficult process, but I want to teach you how to handle pointers and string. That is why I have selected this program. After this, I'll teach you a simple method in which I have used for loop. And after that, a simplest method in which I have used the library function. Okay, now let us study this program. Press F7 key. Now you see, this is a array, namely 1. It is a static character array. I have assigned a string OK sir to the static character array 1. Okay, after that, there is a second string, namely 2. It is again a static character array. The dimension of this string 2 is 20. After that, I have declared pointer 1 and pointer 2. Both these pointers are character type of pointer. Okay, so PTR1 is a character type of pointer and PTR2 is again character type of pointer. Clear? Now execute the clear screen function, which will clear the DOS screen. Okay, now see the most important part of this program. I have assigned array 1 to the pointer PTR1. Okay, now you please observe the watch window. Okay, now see, right now the array 1 contains the string OK sir, because we have initialized this array by the string OK sir. After that, just execute this assignment, PTR1 is equal to 1, and see the watch window. Just press F7 key. What happened? Now PTR1 is pointing to the string OK sir. Clear? Now assign the array 2, I mean address of the array 2 to the PTR2. PTR2 is a character pointer. Execute this step and see the watch window. Watch window is as it is. There is no change because right now the array 2 is blank. Okay, we have simply declared this array and PTR2 is pointing to array 2. Clear? Now see the while loop. Execute the while loop and observe the watch window. Now you see, what I am doing is that I am assigning star PTR1, that is dereferencing operator star or PTR1. What is it? It is the value of the element, value of the variable to whom PTR1 is pointing, or value of the variable whose address is stored in PTR1. Right now PTR1 is pointing to the character O, that is first element of the string array 1. So 1 is your first element. ONE1 in the bracket digit 1 is the first element. So PTR1 is pointing to the first element of the array 1. Okay, and we have assigned that value to the star PTR2. Okay, now execute this step and see the watch window. What happened? The array 2 contains capital O and PTR2 is pointing to the capital O. Clear? Now increment PTR1, increment PTR2, and again see the watch window. What happened is that PTR1 is now pointing to the next character, that is capital K. Okay? Now execute while loop, execute this assignment, star PTR2 is equal to star PTR1, and see the watch window. What happened? Now array 2 contains the string OK and PTR2 is pointing to the second character, that is K. PTR1 is pointing right now, it contains a string k, so that is PTR1 is pointing to the second character k. Now increment PTR1, let's see what happened. Now PTR1 is pointing to the blank space between OK and so. PTR2, if you increment this one, I mean if you execute PTR2++, let's see what happened. PTR2 is pointing to the blank space between OK, sir, string. Again execute it. Now this assignment, let's see what happened. Execute this step. And now we know the working of the while loop. Let's continue it. Eyes. So, now this is last step. That's all. And now while loop will be terminated. And now, at last, assign /0 to the PTR2 to terminate the string, because we know that /0 is a string terminating character. Now display the content of array 1 and array 2, and let's see the DOS from what happened. Yes, array 1 contain OK sir, and array 2 also contain OK sir. So I'll revise the concept again. Let's see what happened. We have declared two arrays. One array we have initialized by OK sir. Second array we have not initialized. Then there are two pointers, PTR1 and PTR2. Because of this assignment, PTR1 will point to the array 1 and PTR2 will point to the array 2. And after that, we have copied the string OK sir from array 1 to array 2 by using pointer assignment. Is it clear? Understood the concept? Thank you.